Well, the FDA has just authorized the first rapid COVID-19 at-home test. So the question is, how does it work? How can you get one? And most importantly, can you trust the results? So we're bringing in Dr. Gary Procop, Vice Chair of Education, Pathology, and Laboratory Medicine at Cleveland Clinic Hospital. He joins us now live right now. Doctor, thanks for being with us. So we hear that you're responsible for all the COVID-19 testing at the Cleveland Clinic. So I guess my first question is, this just got approved. We've been talking about it all week. What is it and how does it work?
Well, it's a, as you mentioned, it's an at-home test. It is a molecular test. So we do molecular tests in the laboratory. This is the first at-home test that's actually a molecular test. And so that in itself is an advancement. I think the other advancement is how simple it is to use. And so basically in this kit, becomes a little device that you're going to, along with two AA batteries and a swab and a tube and instructions. And what the company has done is part of their FDA submission was to demonstrate that people could do it effectively. And, you know, there's very simple cartoon drawings that show you exactly what to do, and folks were able to do it successfully.
It looks less invasive too, right? It's just the tip of the nostril rather than back into the sinuses.
Right, not quite as far back. That's a little bit more comfortable. They do want you to swab both sides of the nose and swirl the swab. So it's important that you get a good specimen. That's the first thing that's most important. Then you put it in the tube and you put it in the little reader, and the reader will tell you with a light that it's ready. It'll start to run on its own, and it'll tell you positive or negative within 30 minutes.
And how do you get it? And is there a certain age group that can use it?
Above 14 okay. is what the FDA and the study looked at. And you're asking the most important question, how do you get it? I think everybody's going to be asking that question. And, we'll have to direct you to the company. This is, you know, brand new, so I'm not sure what their distribution is. Our part in this was we participated in the clinical trial.
Okay. So interpret the results for us, doctor. If I took it before Thanksgiving and came back negative, I'm good to go, cleared for Thanksgiving?
Absolutely not.
Okay.
We are, you know, you can't test your way to a safe Thanksgiving. And so I know this is wet blanket, but, you know, everybody wants to see grandma. We want grandma to be around next year.
Right.
And so, no, you cannot test your way to a safe Thanksgiving, because you could be negative because you're extremely early in the course of disease. Too early for any test to detect, or you could get it tomorrow before Thanksgiving. So, you know, it's a tough thing, but postpone Thanksgiving to next summer. Let's get through this surge and keep everyone safe.
And think about the beginning of this when there were hardly any tests, right? Everybody wanted a test and they couldn't get it. So this is a significant advancement.
It really is. And what's another thing that's important to me is we're keeping sick people in their homes. Mm-hmm. They're not coming out to be tested and potentially exposing people along the way. We're also saving personal protective equipment, because a nurse or caregiver doesn't have to gown, glove, mask to take that specimen. They're getting the answer at home. So, you know, I hope that the company can gear up. I hope that other companies follow suit. I think this is pushing the testing out into the community is a good thing.
And being right there, you in the healthcare system, and speaking of the nurses, what is their reaction right now to what's going on? Because that's kind of where it's being affected. We need to keep the health personnel healthy. So what is their reaction even to this advisory statewide here in Ohio?
I got to tell you, these folks really are heroes that I see every single day. But what we really need is the public to mask up and to follow the other mitigation strategies. I mean, we are burning out our most important resources, our doctors and nurses on the front lines, because people don't want to mask up and follow the other strategies. So we really, really need the public to help here. You know, help your doctors and nurses and employ those mitigation strategies.
All right. Dr. Gary Procop, thanks for being with us this morning. We appreciate it.
Thank you.